It's today is March 12th, 2020, and our world is experiencing a global pandemic of the COVID-19 coronavirus, and the NBA, Major League Baseball, March Madness, all of it has been canceled, and our university is closing to in-person classes and in-person education, and we're in this weird moment where our show, Godspell, that we've been working on since January, has been postponed. And I have had the privilege and the opportunity to direct the show. And sitting into the director's seat was not something that I took lightly. It was a responsibility that I felt honored by and called to. This is the story of Jesus. There's no more inspirational story in humankind. And here we are where humanity is struggling and humanity is afraid. And when you're afraid, you need to remember to pray. And our story is about the power of prayer and the power of the lessons and the story of Jesus. And Jesus said, pick up your cross and go up the hill. And the hill that humanity is facing is pretty significant. The individuals that have given their time to be part of our show will be forever in my heart. And tonight, everybody's still healthy. And tonight, it's fine for us to be in the theater together. And for tonight, social distancing and the chaos of all things that are happening in our world, but not for tonight. Tonight, we're going to perform what we have done. Tonight, we're going to get together and we're going to celebrate the power of theater and the power of storytelling. And tonight, we're just going to do what we do best. Smiles on faces.
So today is April 1st, 2020.
It is April 1st, 2020.
This is the scheduled date for opening night for the RMU Colonial Theater's production of Godspell. As you can see, I am unfortunately not backstage in costume, ready to go.
Yeah, another opening, another show. Another opening of another show.
I am unfortunately sheltering in place in my bedroom.
Our production was postponed because of the coronavirus.
And I bet you're wondering why I have boxes in the background. It's because I'm currently unpacking because I'm at home in Avon, Ohio due to the coronavirus.
It is my last collegiate show at RMU. Maybe for a long time since I'm going into the profession of nursing. And
so that was something that was really great that I was really excited to do. Unfortunately, obviously, our time did get cut short.
Opening of the show being today, it's kind of been hard not seeing my friends every single day in rehearsal.
Performing is my favorite thing to do in the whole wide world. I would give anything right now to be on stage.
For me, theater is a place where you build friendships, relationships, and build a family. And this family's going to be with you a long time.
Oh my gosh. As soon as the lights go down, that's the moment for me where I can just get in it, take on the character, and go on the journey. And this show was such a journey. Such...
This was a special show, and theater has been so important to me through all of my education. I don't know what I would do without singing and dancing and acting throughout my life. That's my thing.
I loved that I could make people laugh, and I could make people happy just by doing what I like to do, which is singing and acting. Performing definitely gave me an outlet to express myself in a way that nothing else allowed me to do.
I think I love performing just because I fell in love with it so much at this, Jesus summer camp, which I think is really cool and kind of comes full circle with everything that I was doing with Godspell, because I kind of started with Jesus and then I was ending with Jesus.
My debut acting role was, I was 4 years old and I was Mary in this Christmas play at my church. I was four.
When I first learned that the show was Godspell, I was really excited just because this is one of my favorite shows of all time.
So I've been in this show before in grade school in seventh grade, and it was the first show I ever had a solo for.
I went from knowing nothing about Godspell, very little, to, oh my gosh, this is my favorite show I've ever been a part of ever.
I had just gotten to class and my phone buzzed and I just knew, you just know. John Locke cast list, opened it and scrolled down and I saw Lauren Comito's name as Jesus. And
I was very, very, very shocked and honored and humbled by being casted as Jesus in this show.
45 seconds before class started, I left class and I ran out in the hallway and I called Lauren Comito and I was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. I'm so happy for you. And she like said pretty much nothing because I think she was in shock. But
Tanner and I have a very long relationship in the theater world. We've had many relationships in shows and we too have a very strong relationship.
And then I scrolled down and saw my name is Judas, and I was like, oh boy, here we go. This is gonna be good.
It was very crazy calling my grandma and being like, hey, grandma, yeah, Godspell's the show. It's about Jesus and his disciples, and I got casted as Jesus.
I love that we had a female Jesus. I love it.
So yeah, so that was crazy, full circle, how I was Mary, and then I got casted as Jesus.
And I saw the cast list, and I was like, cool, I have a solo. And then I was like, wait a minute, Jesus is a female. That's cool. That's so cool.
And in fact, I think it was casted perfectly because Lauren was the character of Jesus in her everyday life. And I still like had that same respect to her. Like I felt like when I was on stage with her, I didn't have to act.
But I remember the first time that we sang, God Save the People.
And songs be heard instead of sighs. God save the people.
Whenever Lauren started singing and the choreography and everything, it was just one of those moments where I was like, wow, this is it. Like, this show means more to me than I think most people know.
When we blocked Save the People, that was the number when Jesus was being introduced to all of his disciples, and there was a specific moment with each disciple. Eric and I had a very funny, fun, great moment. It makes me just smile every time I think about that. When we had our introduction in that song, Eric was one of the statues in a scene in the past show where my character Miss Sandra and all shook up was in the museum singing a song, and at the end everyone on stage did this with their hand, and it was just a very flourished ending of the song. And Eric and I, all around campus, ever since that show, we always see each other and flick our hand like that, just literally across the room. We'll make eye contact and do the move, and it's just something little that he and I had where immediately when they said to do a little motion that represents your relationship, we did that. And
unconditional joy and love that Jesus showed everybody, that
it was just all about the community and bringing people together, and that's personally what I love about Godspell.
With Maddie Maddie and I had a very fun moment. She always goes for this certain dance move. It involves skipping the feet back and forth like a penguin, just shaking off the snow off of his feathers, and that's her iconic move.
Memorable Godspell moments I have was before we actually had any rehearsals, and we had like a meeting, and John was telling us all about how everything was going to unfold and what the set was going to look like and all his ideas. And
the theme for RMU Colonial Theater's production of Godspell was going to be focused around technology.
Our set was going to be a wall of monitors. Throughout the show, the monitors would play videos and show images that not only went along with the show, but enhanced the storytelling. Then in Act Two, the wall of monitors would eventually separate, leaving just a few screens center stage that would become the cross that we crucified Jesus on.
There was a whole video team of RMU Media Arts students that were creating videos for this backdrop that was going to be completely interactive and relevant.
So grateful to have gotten to sing and full on rap.
Day by Day was sung by the amazing Aletta.
Day by day, day by day.
Our choreographer Sarah arranged for it to be a yoga scene where everyone was coming in to take Jesus's yoga class, but then Aletta begins to sing to Jesus and she's preparing for the class too, but Jesus decides that Aletta is ready to teach the class. So Aletta was in the very front of the stage, center stage, singing her song, Day by Day, which is by far the best song and the most popular song in the show.
Day by day, day by day. Oh dear Lord, three things I pray.
During rehearsals, right before tech week of the last Colonial Theater production I was in, my great-grandmother passed away. Theater helped me through that. The show really reminded me of her, because she was a very holy woman. She never missed church every single Sunday, and she never, ever missed a show that I was in. My entire life, she came to every single show, sometimes twice. So this show was really a good way for me to be able to dedicate something to her, and that just added even more meaning to it. I got to think of her while I was performing and know that this was for her, not for me.
Our show was going to be an experience for an audience.
It was going to be the performance of a lifetime.
The fact that John told us that we could make the stories our own.
And it was going to be relatable, and it was going to be funny, and it was going to be cool. It was going to be technological.
We were putting this show on together. Like, it was all of us. All of our ideas were heard.
We were sitting there talking about how we could tell this puppet show that they do. They tell the parable of the Great Samaritan. Alex Cladney, he came up with a way of using text bubbles with emojis to tell the story, because in our age now, that's how we tell stories.
A Samaritan who was making a journey came upon him, and when he saw him, he was moved to pity. He went up and bandaged his wounds, bathing him in oil and wine. And wine.
Yay!
And then he got sick. One
of my favorite days by far was when President Tucci came and visited us. He works at Robert Morris University. He actually had the opportunity to become the president for the day.
And then when I see all of you, it's like I went to heaven because you're all a bunch of angels. So you're doing the best musical, and you're going to send a great message out of this musical.
Yeah. And we got the opportunity to sing with him. Our last day as a cast definitely was my favorite moment. I was kind of sobbing, and I didn't know if I wanted to stay. I didn't know if I wanted to say goodbye, you know, because it sucks. Nobody likes to say goodbye, and then we decided that we were going to sing through Act 2, which we unfortunately didn't get to during regular rehearsal.
When we all came together on the last day and we found out, hey, we're not going to get to perform the show. So we did it. We did the show. With scripts in hands, no costumes on. I never sung through my song before.
Gigi, I am very, very upset that we weren't able to perform our number together by my side.
And we sang through it, and it was kind of a mess, but it was kind of great at the same time.
Was able to sing with her that one last rehearsal, which was just an honor.
I was so excited to sing my song and like walk down the aisle.
Amber Antle, she sang Turn Back, Oh Man, and the only time we heard her sing it as a collective was at the final rehearsal, and she knocked it out of the park.
I was really, really excited to sing that song. I was really, really excited for this to be like, yeah, opening of Act 2, like, just hit them hard and...
Josh Herrera, unfortunately, we were not able to see him perform We Beseech Thee in front of everyone. He would have killed it. His energy on stage, his facial expressions alone can take all of the attention to be drawn onto him at exactly the right moments. He is such a strong, powerful actor, as we can see through all of the shows, because he's been a part of all of the production since he came onto RMU campus. So We Beseech Thee is such a fun number that we all just totally vibed with. He's so talented. He was singing All Good Gifts in our show, which was planned to be such an emotional number.
If there was one moment I wish the audience got to see, it would be just with the screens on our platform, running through pictures of our family, our friends, and past loved ones during All Good Gifts, because whenever I was singing it during that last rehearsal, whenever we all started singing it, it was really hard to hold back the emotions that were built up inside me.
Something that really hit home for me was the scene where Phil sings All Good Gifts. So All Good Gifts is my favorite song in the show. The message behind the song and the direction we were moving with it was something that was so heartwarming and so amazing. And I truly wish that was probably the moment that I wish that people could have gotten to see, because I was...
This is something I've been waiting for a long time, and the fact that I finally got to sing it for everyone was something I was really proud of.
Kim, she is such an honest, passionate actor and person. She sang the song Learn Your Lessons well.
Bless the Lord. I love that song.
Morgan sang Bless the Lord and just was such a wonderful, fun number, and she killed it as the leading lady, powerhouse of that scene.
I had the opportunity to sing Bless the Lord, and it is a song that I've always wanted to sing. It's a dream of mine to have this opportunity.
Morgan singing Bless the Lord, the big old belt song in Act One.
Oh, I hope Morgan has her time, and you know, she got the song, and I was so excited. And of course, my tambourine. Okay, the amberine, it's the best.
Bless the Lord, there is a special surprise.
So one of the things that I wanted to contribute to the show was a split.
Confetti streamers.
During the first week of rehearsal, I tried to put a split in the show, and John looked at me and he said, I was wondering how long it would take you to try to put a split in the show.
And all the confetti is such a fun number. I think that the audience would have really loved it.
Bless the Lord, my rock and roll.
night of rehearsal, I rushed into that split and ended up blowing my hamstring. In that moment, the theater was just filled with love and compassion, and people just wanted to know that I was okay.
We were giving it our all. We were having so much fun too, because we knew this could be the last time that we ever did this. So I do believe that we all got closer that day, and we all cherished, you know, what it meant to be in that show together.
It was cool to see how the show in such a short period of time impacted my life and the other people in the cast, all of our lives.
And I think through this show, or the short time that we did have, it kind of opened me up to my religion and with my beliefs, and being able to kind of re-embrace that, because I think I lost it. And I think since, you know, everything has happened, the show has really been a blessing to kind of show me that, you know, God is there.
My grandmother was my biggest supporter, and she, when I was growing up, she always took us to church. And so Godspell has a place in my heart, because she was very religious, and I loved the theater, and she was supporting me, I'd support her, and this was kind of like a mashup of the two.
The stories just meant that no matter what, that Jesus loves us, no matter what we're going through, that God's always watching, and there's always a light at the end of the tunnel, no matter how dark things may be at the time.
It's so important to give people the unconditional love, support, joy that the gospel teaches to us now more than ever.
I work at West Penn Hospital as a nurse's assistant. It's terrifying. The job is hard. I come home most days pretty emotional, because I do come in contact on a day-to-day basis with a lot of these COVID patients, you know, and I think that's where this show is a blessing too. You know, now that I am more in touch with my faith and kind of counting my blessings.
And when we were putting on this show, I felt a sense of peace, and I believe in God, and I felt maybe, hey, this is God. And for those of you that don't believe in God, that's okay. You still want to love the show.
And just like Kim sings in her song, we have to learn our lessons well. We have to believe in ourselves that we are strong enough to get through this time. We have to believe in our communities.
I'm just so thankful for everybody that I got to share the stage with that, that added so much originality and so much of their own personality in this show.
Watching these performers do what they love, you know, people are there letting songs be heard instead of sighs. So I really think that we can all find the beauty in this.
I was getting really, really excited, you know, to come out here and take my final bows on the stage and finish strong. But obviously that's not what's gonna happen right now.
Oh, this is the weirdest time of all of our lives. But to have theater, to have a place to hang our hat, to have God and Jesus in our life, and to have tonight was really, really special. And yeah, I'm an eternal optimist. So I hope that one day we see the show live from an audience that it deserves. But if that's not in the plan, then tonight was a great way for us to wrap. So thank you.
Everything's going to be okay. God is going to save the people, and we are learning our lessons well, and we will take this pandemic day by day.
Hi, this is Stephen Schwartz saying hello to the cast and crew and company of the production of Godspell at Robert Morris University that got canceled. I'm so sorry, guys, that the show was canceled, but I hope you had fun working on it till then, and I hope when theater gets up and going again, the next productions you do will be even more fun. Thank you so much for at least trying to do my show, and I send you all my best.